Hey everybody, welcome back to another PC port report. Today we're going to be taking a look at Alan Wake Remastered. Now in this award-winning cinematic action thriller, the troubled author Alan Wake embarks on a desperate search for his missing wife Alice. Alan Wake Remastered offers a complete experience with the main game and its two-story expansions, The Signal and The Writer. Now you can get this game for $29.99 on the Epic Games Store. One quick side note about Alan Wake Remastered, it does require an online connection to Epic's servers. I don't understand why a single-player game that has no multiplayer components requires an online connection, but I'd like you to at least be aware of that. Also, it does have de novo as well. The first thing you'll notice with Riva Tuner is CPU cores 1 and 5 are being taxed very heavily compared to the other cores on my 8700. We're using 10 gigs of RAM. We are also sitting at 141 FPS because I do have G-Sync enabled. However, 21% of the GPU is actually being used. So we're not really being GPU bottlenecked. It looks to be more of a CPU bottleneck, but in how the game actually utilizes cores and threads. There is widescreen resolution. There is ultra widescreen resolution as well. It does have a field of view slider, which is fantastic. And it does have some pretty good options in this game. However, though, it does not have HDR or ray tracing. The game does, however, have Nvidia DLSS and some other things as well. Let's go ahead and check out the options menu like we do in every single port report. Today we're going to take a look at the controls. So we do have full key bindings, which is really nice. You can just rebind anything you need there. However, you cannot rebind your controller. That's something I did notice as well. We do have sensitivity options as well for vertical and horizontal if you need them. Direct aiming, I don't really even know what that actually means, but I would like to have some sort of idea as to what it actually does in game. Some sort of explanation around there would be really great. For if you're going to use a controller, you can adjust the sensitivity, how you are on foot. You can have the different sort of changes, default or alternative. I would really like the ability to go ahead and rebind any buttons if need be, but apparently we don't have that option here, unfortunately. So you can do that while you're on foot or you're driving, as well as swapping control sticks and or triggers. Now, let's take a look at the graphics options because that's usually the most important thing. We do have full screen resolution. We also have ultra wide screen, so that's also good as well. There is Nvidia DLSS. I'm going to turn that off for the meantime so that way we can get a good view of how the game actually runs on the 2070 Super. V-Sync is off because we are going to be using G-Sync to remove any stutters. There was some slight stuttering, but nothing too outlandish compared to other games. The frame times do stay somewhat in line. Now, there is an FOV slider, thank the goodness, because we do really require that in PC games. FOV sliders, I think, are incredibly important, especially for third-person games, or pretty much any game, just because I don't want to be so close to my character, and it does help with people who are motion sick. So, brightness will keep the same. Motion blur and film grain, chromatic aberration, and depth of field, these are options that we remove on this channel. So we only have motion blur and film grain. Those are disabled right off the bat. We're not even going to look at those. For advanced options, we are going to be taking a look on the high settings. I wanted to remove TAA, FXAA, and MSAA because I feel they add a bit of the smeared Vaseline look onto a lot of images. I'd rather just have anisotropic filtering just straight off the bat 16 times. Some people do swear by MSAA. I personally don't, but to each their own. I'm going to lower it just a smidge because it is going to be taxing on the frame rate, as you'll see why. Terrain quality and light quality will stay high. Draw distance will be all the way. Again, another PC port that does not have the ability to see what the game will look like once you make a change. That is so necessary in so many ports because we have so many options. Additionally, there is no actual description about what these options actually do. So, if you're going to be messing with anisotropic filtering or shadow quality or volumetric light quality, they are self-explanatory to some people or the majority of PC gamers, but for others, unfortunately, they don't really know what's going on with these actual settings, and they don't really know how it'll impact their actual hardware. So there is no way of knowing how it will impact your game performance. There is no way of knowing what the game will look like when you make these changes, and that is a bad thing. This is something that I have been preaching for the longest time, why so many other game developers do not provide this. Although the lighthouse is very nice to look at, it does not give me a quality of life as to how the game will run or what will happen in terms of frame rate or visual fidelity when I make these changes. I say this every single port report, Resident Evil 2 Remake did it the best. I know it's a broken record, but we'll continue on. Let's go ahead and take a look at the audio. Music volume, effects volume, speech, and cinematic, pretty basic there as well. Subtitles we're going to enable, which is really nice. Enable font size, which this is fantastic. Because there are so many times subtitles are too small to be read. And when you're playing either on a monitor or on a big TV, it just boggles my mind how people don't really understand the size of fonts. Bring back PS2 font size. It was perfect. Background opacity, so if you want to make it opaque, you can. Video commentary, we're going to disable for now. Let's go ahead and boot up a new game, because the beginning section is probably the most dramatic and has the most visual flair in the game. Now, the FMVs do run at full frame rate, but I do want you guys to realize that a lot of the visual quality in this game is not really that great compared to the original. And that's something that I've noticed right off the bat. We're going to go ahead and skip that though. So at the settings that we have, we're getting at about 78 to 80 FPS. We're sitting at about 11.8 millisecond frame time, which is pretty good. Nothing too shabby. We don't see any massive spikes. And if we want to see the 1% lows with Nvidia performance overlay, we are getting, wow, that is a little bit of a dip here and there. But I'm going to account that to just the actual spike of turning on the overlay. Our 1% lows and our average FPS are relatively close to each other. The average I'm seeing is about 10 to 12 FPS off, which of course does fall in line with our frame time. So that does look pretty good. I'm not really too upset about that. So kudos to that end. However, we are seeing 77% GPU utilization around there. But CPUs 1 and 5 are still being taxed incredibly heavily. So even if you have a very high-end CPU, this game seems to be CPU-bound more so than GPU-bound. It looks as though the GPU is not truly being utilized, because we shouldn't be sitting at this sort of utilization with this sort of CPU usage. I just saw it jump up to 91% usage on Core 1. This is a massive, massive issue that needs to be fixed, because we don't want to have these kind of bottlenecks on the CPU side, especially just sitting at around 80 FPS or an 8700. That's pretty ridiculous. And even CPU Core 5, 7 a little bit as well.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Let's go ahead and keep going down this way. Run away.
Recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff? Play with people's lives and kill them when you think it adds to the drama.
Let's see if we can actually get past this area here.
You missed your deadline.
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I'd been working on.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
So we are getting a little bit of a stutter in the frame time, as you can see on MSI Afterburner. with your Riva tuner, so we're going to go ahead and take a look at that. Some spikes here and there, so frame times are inconsistent, but I think that has more to do with the CPU cores being taxed. Also, it looks as though there is actual mouse acceleration. It's not reverse mouse acceleration like we've seen before. If I move it just a smidge too fast, I can really just swing all the way around in a full 180 or 360. And I'm not even really moving my mouse that much. So that seems to be in play. So for some reason, they really just decided to add that. And I wish we could actually remove it. We are dipping into the 70s for frame rate. It's really not holding up too bad for really being pigeonholed by two cores. Let's see.
I was trapped. There was no way out.
Let's take a look at our 1% lows again. So we are getting quite a bit of CPU usage, and our 1% lows are sitting between 14 to 15 frame rate difference. So not too shabby, but still, the GPU usage is not where it needs to be, and neither is the CPU usage. So be aware of that if you're going to be purchasing this game. I think with a little bit of patching, though, and some work, they may be able to fix this. Let's go ahead and turn on DLSS and see if we actually get some sort of visual change. We'll go ahead and put it on balance to begin with in frame rate. So we did get a bit of a bump. GPU usage did drop to about 58%, but we are still seeing CPU usage to be incredibly high.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deep...
So NVIDIA DLSS may not even be the thing that you need to get that higher frame rate. It just seems to be the way they've designed this. 32% GPU usage on... Oh no. 49% GPU usage for ultra performance. But we did have CPU usage still stay flat on cores 1 and 5 still. So this game is definitely not perfect, but it is definitely one of the better ports that I have seen recently, especially after Kenna and Deathloop and others. But there is still a lot of work to be done here. GPU usage is not really working correctly. Cores 1 and 5 on the CPU don't really work as well. They're being overly taxed and bottlenecked. So there are a few things to be noticed in here, but frame time is not atrocious, and the mouse acceleration may be a factor for some of you. Anyways, that's going to be it for now. Thank you so much for watching. I do appreciate it. If you want to see more, please subscribe to the channel. It does mean a lot. If you want to check me out on Twitch and Twitter, you can. It's at Oh No, It's Alex. If you want to join the Discord, the link to that is in the description down below. Hope you guys have a great one, and I'll see you next time.